Hello everyone, welcome to Programming Cradle. So today in this video I would like to talk about my profile. As you all know that I'm applying for masters in foreign universities, and to apply to foreign universities you need to have a good portfolio or profile. So, and also I have got offer from some of the good universities. Actually I'm applying to colleges in UK and in Ireland. So I have got offer from Russell Group Universities in UK. So if you don't know about Russell Group Universities, it's like a if you know about universities in India, you know universities like IITs and NITs. So just like them, there they have Russell Group. So whichever universities are part of Russell Group, they are usually good universities in terms of research work and teaching quality and all those things. So yeah, they are actually reputed. So yeah, I have offer from those universities. So of course I think my profiles stand out for them, and it also matters how you present your profile. Maybe when I will tell you numbers, you won't feel like yeah, it is a very exceptional thing, but when you know how to present it, that in that way probably it will help you. So yeah, I will talk about right from my 10th class to till today. So how much ever marks I have got and what all I did, I will talk about everything so that you will get a clear picture of what all you need to do, and if you have all those things then probably you will get good universities as well. So it holds good for any university, I mean in any country. So if you will have a profile like that, you can obviously apply to any universities in any part of the world. So yeah, but before moving further, if you are new here or if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please go subscribe to the channel and also hit the bell icon so that you get notified each time when a video goes live, and also hit that like button because it keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys. And if you have any suggestion, feel free to let me know in the comment section, or if you want to know something, again you can post it in the comment section. I will be more than happy to help you. Now with that being said, let's start our discussion. So in my 10th, I had CGPA of 8.6, so maybe that won't excite you. And then when I moved to 12th, in my 12th I had 82% in CBSE board. So my subjects were physics, chemistry, maths, English and physical education. So till then I was pretty much very unfamiliar with computer science or programming languages. So I chose computer science because I was interested in computers and all the applications which were built. So I chose computer science as my bachelor's in engineering. So I completed my BE with 70% from Visveshwaraya Technological University. And yeah, that's what I got in my BE. I will talk more about it after I tell you all the schools which I have and the experience which I have. So yeah, after that I joined Infosys as a systems engineer, and there I worked for 1.5 years, and I was a part of a big data team, and I will talk more about it again. So after I left my company, I was actually preparing for a GATE exam, and I had like 2 months. So I left my company in November 2019 and I took GATE in Feb 2020. So I had almost 2 months to prepare, and I prepared and I got rank of around somewhere around 5000, which if you see in a percentile manner, it will be top. I was in top 6% because overall the students who took the exam, they were approximately 1 lakh candidates, or maybe 96,000, somewhere around that. So yeah, I was in top 6-7%. So that way it looks attractive, but yeah, you know, with 5000 rank you don't get any good colleges in India. And by the time I got results, I was able to convince my parents that I want to go abroad to study. So yeah, they agreed, and then I left my GATE counseling and all those things, and I started focusing on my SOP and LOR and all those things to apply to foreign universities. And for that I had to take IELTS exam. So I took IELTS exam and I got band 7, and I have talked about my IELTS exam in detail in this video. You can check out here, and so I think these are my scores. Now I will go back to my college, what all I did in my college, and I will talk about that as well. And so in my college there used to be a thing called as IPL, Innovative Programming Lab, so or Innovative Project Lab. So there you had opportunity to work on any idea that you have, and I was very much interested in working on all type of different ideas. So I had worked a lot and I had made several projects. So and also I did my final year project, which was very complicated as per my guide and my HOD. So my final year project was road sign detection and recognition system. So that was, and we actually did it in a live way. So we had a toy auto and we placed a camera on top of it, and when we moved the toy auto, and we had made a miniature model. So as and when the camera moved closer to the road sign, it detected it and it gave audio output. So it was actually a very practical project. It was not just like throwing an image and getting audio output in the system. So it was not like that. So because of all those things, my HOD was very much familiar with me, and when I asked her to give me a good LOR, and she was very much willing to give me, and it actually helped me to build my profile. And so that was my university or my college thing. And when I moved to Infosys, I worked there for 1.5 years, which I know is not very significant in terms of experience, but I did quite a lot of things there. My personal responsibilities and things which I used to do, it was not very interesting, but as I was a part of a big data team, there were many people and sub teams which were doing projects on a very interesting thing. So there were teams who were working with Python and all, and there were teams who were working with Java. So there was a team, they were familiar with all the big data tools, and they were familiar with Scala and all, but they didn't know Java much, and I was pretty much good with Java. So I helped them to a greater extent, and they were able to do their project in relatively lesser time. And that was the thing. And then I also helped people who were working with Python. In Infosys, it's not like if you are trained on some particular technology, you will get project from that technology itself. So the people were there in the project, but they were not actually familiar with all those technologies, but I knew Python and Java, so I helped them, and it was quite useful for them. So again, when I asked my, even after leaving, and it is more than a year now, and still I asked my team lead to give a LOR to me, and she was again willing to give LOR, and she was kind enough to do that for me. So because of these two LORs, I was able to prove that I have that credibility, and I have actually done quite a lot of things during my university and during my work. So, and also I wrote my SOP, so I included everything in my SOP as well. To prove these things, I had LOR from my HOD and from my team lead. So this is what these are the things which made my profile a standout, I guess. I won't say it was exceptional, because if it was exceptional, by now I would have got admit from University of Edinburgh, which is in top 10 in the world for AI and machine learning. Of course, ranking will matter from various sources, so which source you follow, but still, if you search for top universities in research in AI and machine learning and data science, University of Edinburgh is one of the best universities. So I am still waiting for them to reply, but even if I get an offer from them, their fees is way too high, so I need to have some scholarship from them to pursue the course in that particular university. That's why I didn't apply to other universities like King's College or LSC, or there are many other universities like Oxford or Cambridge. So I didn't apply to those universities because the fee structure or the fees is way too high for me. So I was okay with other universities from Russell Group. So I applied to those universities, and also I made sure that the course structure is good and the modules which I want to pursue are there, because even if the university is good, there were many universities like University of Birmingham. I didn't like the course structure of Birmingham University. So yeah, that is the thing. So that's why I had to choose which university to go to, and I have got offer from almost all the universities where I applied to. I'm just waiting for University of Edinburgh to reply, and I can understand they get quite a lot of applications, so they need time to review. But it's been a month now, and probably by now I should have got reply from them, but still I don't have any reply from them. So I'm hoping that I will get a rejection. So it is what it is. So yeah, let's see what happens. And even if I get offer from Edinburgh, like I told you, it is way out of my budget. So yeah, let's see how it goes. And today is what, 19-20? Yeah, so at the time of shooting this video it's 20, and the time is 2 o'clock in the morning. So yeah, maybe by today or tomorrow I will finalize which university I want to go to. And I have also talked about how to choose a particular university, or how to choose a particular country to study for your master's, or even if you want to go for undergrad, you can follow those parameters. I will leave the link into the description, or I will leave a card here. You can check out those videos as well. So yeah, this is what I wanted to discuss in this video. And did I miss something? Let me check. So no, not exactly, I didn't miss anything. Yeah, one more thing, I published a paper also when I was in my final year. So it was, I published a paper about my final year project, which was road sign detection and recognition. So if that is something which improved my profile, so that can again be one of the factors. So this is what I want to discuss in this video, and this is all about my profile. So I might not have a very exceptional profile, but it totally depends on how you have kept your relationship with your co-workers or your team lead, or with your university teachers. So it actually matters, and again it depends how well you are able to write your statement of purpose or personal statement. So yeah, those are the things, and they are actually very important. And in many cases university will ask you to write essays on several other topics. Like in my case, one of the universities asked me to write essay on ethics in data science. So I was able to write it in a relatively lesser time, because I had experience in writing SOP multiple times. And if you want to know how to write a SOP, I have actually made a video here, you can check that out. And if you want to know how to write SOP for every university, like personalized SOP for every university, and in a very lesser time, you will have to just change few things here and there. If you want to know that, let me know in the comment section. I will try to make that video as well. So yeah, this is what I want to discuss in this video, and hope to see you in the next video. Bye, happy learning. But don't forget to subscribe, share, like and comment, all those good things, and they are free. So, and it keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys. So yeah, bye.